Hello, YouTubers. Welcome back. This is our form videos. This is going to be part two. Sam broke down our feet and where they're supposed to be and how it helps the rest of our body, what placement they're supposed to be in, and how much distance it actually added. So if you missed that one, go ahead and check that video. And then this video, we're going to be getting into part two. We're going to be working on our hips and how they create more power. The hips don't lie. Most people do things a little wrong, so we're going to see if we can create a little better habits for the newer and more improved players as well. Let's get into it. All right, this video we're going to be working on our hips, like we said, so we're going to have Sam throw here. But one common mistake that we see with a lot of newer players is they spin as fast as they can to create all the power that they can to throw as far as they can, which isn't all wrong. But it's more of what you're doing with that spin and the direction you're going with your body to get the most distance out of your throw. So as you saw with those throws, he got them out there and he got them a good distance. They're out there straight, but he got a little nose down, a little turnover on both of them. What I'm seeing is his hips doing this, like very spinny and no forward momentum at all. And what that creates is this goes up to your shoulders and it does the exact same thing and it has to follow exactly what your hips do. So if your hips don't create that forward motion, then your shoulder and your arm and your hand don't create that forward motion for the disc to fly forward as well.
Another thing I noticed is it actually kind of hurt my arm a little in here because I was trying to just spin and my follow through, there was something weird about it. Mm-hmm. It just didn't feel like, kind of like you were saying, there was no forward movement to it to allow space to follow through because I was just focusing on spinning and trying to get the disc out as much as I could.
All right, so that was issue one. That was spinning too much. Now issue two is almost kind of the opposite, where it's not allowing yourself to follow through with your hips and almost creating a back with your back leg. You kind of kick backwards and it kind of stops the rest of your body from creating the spin. So let's look into Sam throwing with that bad form as well and kind of show that and see how we can fix that in the future as well. So now with that one there, that created almost a no spin. As he threw it, the leg kicked back and his hips are only going right here. They're not doing the extra spin. They're not spinning at all. Now that also creates the opposite end of the bad, where before he was turning it over, now he's not being able to turn it over at all. And he's gonna need a lot flippier disc to create that distance and get the distance he needs. So let's try to work on how to get your hip swing to get a little bit more forward and creates a lot easier power without too much strain on your body. So here's our last throw here with the good form on everything, throwing with our new MVP Open, the Streamline Echo here, which will potentially be a giveaway at the end of this video. So let's check it out.
All right, folks. So if you're enjoying this content and you appreciate our 50 plus years of experience of mostly getting things wrong, but then fixing it and getting it right, like and subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us into the podcast room where we get a little bit more detailed into what the hips are good for.
Welcome back into the podcast room. We're here to look at a little more breakdown of the videos to see if we can slow it down and see them side by side. So let's take a little bit more at the pole drill that we were kind of doing to see the three versions of the throw, the bad, and the good again. So starting out here, this is the ultra spinny. He winds up really well, but instead of moving forward, it was more of a spinny action. And as we move into the next pull, you can see it was more of a kickback with the back foot and the hips not really being able to push forward, not being able to turn over the disc and everything. Sam, what do you have to say about those two types of throws before we get into more of the good?
Yeah, so my take is the follow through is, a lot of it is about that left hip and where it ends up after the throw. And when you look at the over rotation, as you can see here, the wind up is good. And then as it rotates, it comes all the way through and over rotates. So the consequence of that is your release point is a little bit more variable. So you're trying to almost let go at the right point. And also you may be ripping on the disc and you may experience sometimes some grip lock where it goes off to the right way fast, which is like kind of like a, oh wow, that went far, but the wrong direction. And in converse with the one where your hips aren't rotating enough and you're almost mm-hmm. stalling out and using your back leg as balance to try and keep yourself from falling over, you're not getting the same power. You might be getting a little bit more consistent forward movement, but you're missing on the power that your hips can provide to your throw.
Yeah, let's move into a little more of a video of three side-by-side videos of all three of them working together and then stopping a little bit more at the release point. So you see it roll through there. Let's go back to right at the release point on all three of these side by side. All right, so this is right after the release point of the disc. As you can see, the good being in the very middle, the left being the back leg kickback, the anti-balance we'll go with, and then the right one is the overturned. The right one, to me, doesn't look that much different than the one in the middle, other than your shoulders are a lot less balanced. You can tell you turned it over quite a bit. Mm-hmm. And your hips are a little bit pointed a little more in front of you. Where in the middle, the good, we see your hips are nice and firm. You're up over that front leg. You're balanced with the back leg up. You have a nice balance. I'm personally a foot dragger. So it may look slightly different just with my foot down, but I'm still similarly balanced as him, and he has a little more control with his shoulders. And then the left for me, you can tell you're not able to move your hips. It's almost like you're too staggered in your stance, yeah. Kind of like what we were talking about in our last video, is just if you're not quite comfortable with your footwork, it may be easier to do the left side of mistake. What about you?
Yeah, I think that left side, you can kind of tell that a common error is going to be an early release and that it's going to come out on hyzer normally. And so folks who have the issue where they're not rotating their hips through are going to have a problem with turnover shots because they're not rolling their hips over enough to be able to get the correct angle. Whereas on the other side, you look at the over rotation, it's going to be really hard for them to maybe throw a tall sky hyzer because they're really rotating and that's where they're trying to get their power from. But it's going to give you a lot less ability to do like a frisbee skill shot, mm-hmm. so to say. It takes away some of the finesse. And so in the middle, you kind of get that balance where you're using your hips with the power, but it's going forward to be able to drive the power and also drive the consistent release going forward.
All right, so there you have it. You've seen all of our throws, or the three types of throws that we have, hoping to fix the two common mistakes that people make with their hip area. As we kind of make our way up the body with these videos, if you like this video, please comment on if it helped you at all. And also, I think we have some sort of giveaway.
We do. Just like in the last video, we're going to be giving away one of the discs that we were kind of testing in the field. As you saw, it has a nice kind of flip up to straight, and it is the Cosmic Neutron Echo. It's got a pretty stamp on there from the MVP Open from hole 8, kind of looking from the crowd towards the basket. Iconic hole, love that hole, and a great flight to the disc.
For sure.
Usable for just about
any
anybody.
Level. Yep.
Yeah, and so the way you get into this giveaway is you like and you comment and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And in your comment, please leave your Instagram handle if you have one, because that'll help us track you down and send you a message and be able to get your address so we can send you this gorgeous disc.
Thank you. Have a nice one.